Hey guys, I'm Mr. 53 here from Not So Daily Gaming. We're back with another tutorial. Today, we're going to start the Cessna. If it wants to do that. There we are. Alright, great. And I figured we'd go over the autopilot, because that's something that a lot of people have been having trouble with. And it's actually pretty easy to figure out. So, before we get up in the air, if we're going to go up in the air at all, we'll figure that out as we go along. We're actually just going to turn it on now, and I'll explain all the functions of what it can do. And all that stuff, because you actually don't need to be in the air for it to work. So, if we turn it on, you'll notice it has this selection right here. Roll means it's trying to keep the wings level. So, for instance, if we were to be tilted sideways, it would try to keep the wings level by keeping the rate of turn at zero, which has some interesting, interesting stuff happens because of that. Vertical speed, if we were traveling up or if we were traveling down, the autopilot would automatically try and keep that speed going up or down to this altitude right here, I believe. If we go and click heading, now we are trying to go to a certain heading, and you notice the yokes did turn there. And that's using this. So you'll notice how as I'm turning the heading bug, it is attempting to steer in that direction. So, which is nice, because once you have the heading bug where you want it to be, you can just let it go, let the autopilot, and it will automatically follow that heading. If you press it again, it goes back to keeping the wings level. Nav. So if we have currently we have some beacon in here. Let's see what one it is. Taking longer than usual to load because I am recording. We'll see though. Come on. There we go. Okay, so we do have, for whatever reason, there must be some nav beacon, that it is trying to find. Although now you guys are seeing how laggy my computer is, which is fine. But whatever. So if it had this, if this was tuned to a certain frequency, there we go. So it appears that it's trying to find this beacon here, although I'm not entirely sure that's actually accurate. Well, it is kind of, I guess, but it shouldn't be picking up from that distance. Anyway, so if we have the beacon in here, we can adjust the radial, which is fine, but if we have the beacon in there, we can actually basically go towards it. If we turn that on, it'll try to find the nav, and it'll attempt to go towards it. We're going to turn just back to heading, please, if it will load. There we go. Okay. Back to roll. Approach, it does basically the same thing as nav. Oh, and forgot to mention that nav also, if you have the GPS and you're using the GPS, nav will automatically, if you have some sort of program in the GPS, it will follow that automatically, which is really pretty cool, or we'll use nav one. Approach. Same thing as nav, however, it strictly uses the beacon, and it will use the glideslope as well. So this approach will take over altitude control, which is cool. Rev is kind of interesting. What rev does is it basically flies away from whatever beacon you have it. So let's assume that we are flying from this airport, okay, and we're taking off in this direction towards the south-ish. If we turn on rev, it would automatically follow this heading here automatically and stay on that. It would not go higher or lower, so this is not an altitude control button, but it will go and stay in that straight line away from it. Again, we're just going to go back to this to keep it simple. Altitude tells it to go up or down to a certain altitude, and then at what speed it should go to that altitude. And then again, you can change it here, what altitude you should be going to. So you can do that there. Altitude arm, I'm not entirely sure what that does, but alarm, I think. It may give an alarm when you reach an altitude. I'm still trying to figure that one out. But barometer, you can change your barometer settings so the autopilot knows where it is. But the arm, again, that's the one button on here that I'm not entirely sure of. But for an autopilot, so let's go ahead. We have just a little bit of time here. We'll go ahead and take it up into the air, and then that'll be it. So, we're going to turn the autopilot off for now, because we want to do a landing. Go up to full throttle here, and see what happens. So, we'll just take off, and I'll show you simply some of the features that you will use on a day, you know, a flight data day, I guess. And this is kind of cool for like approaching airports and stuff, because it means that if ATC wise, you don't need to worry about a thing. All right, so we're up in the air now. So I'm gonna go ahead and attempt to get to a pretty stable condition here. So this looks pretty stable to me. And if I click autopilot, it's saying, hey, you need to go. So now we're going to change it to go up. So now we're going at 100. We should be going 100 feet per minute up. And then you saw that there. But notice how the wings are becoming level here. They're doing a good job of that. And if we tell it, hey, I want to go even faster up, we can go, hey, let's go up at 1,000 feet per minute. And if you look here, it is able to keep it basically right on that bar. It's kind of varying right now. But it's having no problem. Yeah, you'll see it'll slowly kind of come onto it. Have no problem doing that. Now, if we turn to heading, notice how the plane automatically turns. It's going to follow that heading bug right there. Oop, it ran into some challenges there. But you can see fairly simply, it can just follow that heading bug. And it's not following it exactly because it's keeping track of, if we look at our equipment, it is not, it's not perfectly that line is our path of travel and the airplane is heading. Not perfectly aligned, so it's automatically accounting for that. At least it should be. I'm not entirely sure. But you can change that, and if I want to change it, notice how it automatically turns. Again, I have not, ever since a couple, like 30 seconds ago, I have not touched my joystick at all, which is kind of cool. And it will continue to climb to whatever frequency we tell it to. So that's kind of cool. We'll just go really fast down to, like, say 5,000 or 1,500-600 or something, and see what happens. Okay, here we go. Okay, we'll just see. 6, and we'll arm. Okay, so it is armed, so let's see what happens when I reach this altitude. Okay, so whoa, what happened there? All right, so basically, it said, hey, all right, we're at the 1,600-foot mark. Now, let's go ahead and keep it that altitude. So that's what the arm button does, is it allows you to go to up to a certain altitude and stay at that altitude once you get there. So that's pretty cool. And now we're just flying totally autonomously, basically. I'm going to go ahead and decrease throttle, though. Again, this does not have automatic speed control, which is probably good for a plane like this. But that's basically it. So thank you guys all very much for watching. This has been another video by EMHC3, and I will talk to you guys later. Bye-bye.